Welcome to Opalesque Television. I'm in Shanghai and I have the great pleasure to be with Ping Jiang. He is the founder of Ping Capital. And Ping has a very interesting background. Ping, please tell us, what is your career? How did you get started and what are your credentials?
I was originally a scientist. I was trained as a chemist in China. And then I went to US. I finished a PhD chemist from Princeton. But then after that, I studied finance. I spent 2 years at Stanford and went to Lehman Brothers. I started there as a research person. Gradually, I started trading Mexican peso options. Gradually, I become the head of the Latin American currency and local debt market trading. In 2005, I left Lehman. I went to SAC, Steve Cohen's hedge fund
in Connecticut.
Connecticut, I was hired by supposed to work in Connecticut, but I actually worked in New York most of the time.
Okay.
But I worked for him directly. I had a team of at one point of 24 people between New York and the Shanghai. We traded the emerging market, mostly emerging market globally, Latin America, China, Asia, a little bit of Eastern Europe also. In 2008, I left SAC and started the Ping Capital.
So Lehman and SAC Capital, tell me more, Ping. What did you do there exactly? What was your responsibility there?
At Lehman, I was initially managing Mexican peso options. It was very unusual for a Chinese guy to run a Latin American desk because in 1995, Lehman somehow caught a lot of people in Latin America, so they let me, a junior trader, to run the Latin American trading. So from there, we built a business by 2001, 2002, we had 8 people working for me, and we become the biggest group within Lehman, and our Latin American FX trading, we were probably one of the dominant grouping on the whole street. Despite the size of Lehman being a lot smaller than other shops. At the same time, we had the prop trading in G7 FX and G7 bonds and equity indices. And by 2002, 2003, I was one of the most profitable traders within Lehman globally. So at one point, my VAR was bigger than the VAR of whole foreign exchange business. Global business. So that's in Lehman. And in 2005, I went to SAC. Over there, I built one of the largest team, you know, with over 20 people between New York and Shanghai. And in 2005, 2006, we were one of the most profitable group within SAC. I left SAC in good terms, so I took most of my people, most of my team from SAC. The people, we started with 15, 16 people. Most of them were just original SAC people between New York and Shanghai, half and half. We initially started with employees' own capital, which is a little over 20 million. We started in March of 2008. It was difficult in general at that point, but it was reasonably easy for us to get funding. It took us a few months to negotiate to get the best deal. We eventually got one of the biggest fund family in London. They backed us. We had a very good term and the initial funding came in. In 2008, in September and October, we had a problem. We had 20% of capital trapped in Lehman. You can see because of my relationship with Lehman, they were my prime broker. And thankfully, we had another prime broker. We only had 20% of money there. And because of that, our investor pulled out. So the fund shrank dramatically back to employees' own capital. We had below average 2008, and we have above average 2009. 2009, we are completely focused on trading. We also had some concentration of risk in what we perceive to be the best return opportunity. And as a result, we had a very good year. We were after fee, net of fees, our fee is standard 220, net of fees, we were close to 190 and change. Close to 200.
But unfortunately, you didn't have any investors left in the fund to participate of your bounce back.
We did have a few small investor, family office type of, you know, they really trusted us even at the worst point. I called them, I apologized. I said, we didn't do a good job. They say, you it's fine. You know, lost like 35%. It's not uncommon. I trust you. We trust you. We want to see you fight back. So we fought back. And this return, I want to emphasize, was made with no leverage, zero leverage. We couldn't possibly get any leverage. Our prime broker refused to. I mean, I don't blame them. Okay,
yes.
That's a very unique period. For the whole year, we could not get any financing on anything.
What's the source of the return of those close to 200%? How did you do it?
We have to go back to September, October, November, when we lost a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
Some of it was liquidation. Over 10 years during that, I saw, you know, market drop, and finally, when you think it's great value, you buy, and they just totally collapse. That's the final stage of liquidation. And we were part of that liquidation. We contributed to that, to the loss.
Yes.
But at that point, the valuation was so compelling. And we didn't rely on leverage. We had so much confidence in some of the assets we own. We went long. You know, when we started, we were a little bit of long short. Even now we are, you know, long, mostly long, but we have shorts also. But at that point, we switched to mostly long. And long and trading and selecting which asset to buy, we went long some of the H-share stocks, Chinese stocks, went long some of the Latin American names. In particular, we had a very significant exposure in Argentina.
Mm-hmm.
We believe the assets were just way undervalued. We had a very strong confidence in those assets. To me, it was natural. The coming back was natural. It didn't excite me to see my P&L to be up. I knew I was doing the right thing. It just naturally happened. The market, the asset went back to the level that it should be.
Mm-hmm.
And even this day, it's still some of the assets very attractive. We still hold them from the date we bought them. They went up 3-4 fold. We still hold them. But some of the assets we sold, some of the positions we switched to short. It's the valuation was transparent,
yes.
So that's how it happened.
And what is the current allocation? Where are you exposed to which countries?
At the beginning of 2009, we had the significant exposure in two areas, China and Latin America, in particular Argentina. We had small exposure in other places like labor commodity, a little bit of U.S. sector. I have to say, I'm mostly macro, EMG focused macro. We don't do so much individual companies, individual stocks. We do sectors, indices, and currencies.